Hello guys, welcome back to another video. On today's video, we're diving into how to create a template button inside of Notion. We're going to be diving over to the laptop to show you how you can use it to apply it to a morning routine. I'm actually going to be creating my first ever template button, which is going to be quite exciting, giving you a full overview of how to use it. And that's all on today's video. Okay guys, so I've got my cup of tea ready. I am ready for this feature. This in front of me is my newer Notion setup. You can probably grasp what I've tried doing with it, put it a little bit more simply. In today's video, we'll be explaining how to create a template button, as well as demonstrating something that I wanted to create. I've sort of had it in my head. I've sort of been plotting it out, I guess. Many of you guys may have known that I used to have not a morning tab, but a today tab, where I used to sort of have an area for today items like my checklist and things like that. But it really is an expansion from that. So I want to demonstrate how I would do this and sort of put it into action. So you're going to get a real life demonstration. I'll try and edit out bits of me like sort of like screwing up. But I think that's what's good about Notion is that you can sort of screw up and rebuild. So the template button is really, really simple function inside of Notion. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to create it in this one. I'm going to call it a new page called morning. So I would create a block here. I'd call it morning. What I want to do is add an icon of not cricket, but sunny. So I'm just going to click that one there. So if I go into this one, what I'm going to do to start off with is I'm going to press the slash button. As you can see, all the basic blocks come up and I believe the template button is in one of the advanced blocks there we go, template button. So you can just type that in if you want to, just template button and it will appear. If I hit enter, this configuration of the template appears. And this is where it can get quite tricky for some people. And what you can do is a lot of people, and I know David Pierce has this one, is use the template button just to press or create a new page or create a new entry or something like that. But in this demonstration, I want to create a new page that has something in it already. So that every time I'm creating a template of something. So here we are inside of the template button account. You can see here that once I click in, that sort of shade goes away. Button title. So I'm going to put the button title as, I think I've got it over here as log entry. So I'm going to have that as a log entry, just so that I have a bit of a title. I was working out how to put like today, whether I can put today on there. And I don't know whether I can, but for this example, I'm actually going to do that. So it's going to hopefully come up today and we'll hopefully see tomorrow whether it appears. And I'll try and put a note in the comments whether it does. So you can see down here, these are the actual blocks that will be created when you press this template button. You can drop blocks here. So I didn't actually know this, but when you're actually creating this this element down here, is I would just delete it and start again. You can create some down here. So for example, if I was like, okay, each time I want a table to be created, you can drag this inside of there. And that's literally how you can do it. So essentially here, if I wanted to, I could create a table every time I did this button. So let's just demonstrate this one because this is a good example. If I close this button, I'm like, okay, I'm going to log entry this one and press that. If I click it, a table should appear. It's very simple. So you can do that with anything really. Let me just demonstrate it one more thing before we move on because I think it's good to really demonstrate it. So the way to get back in is this cog in the right-hand corner. If I just delete this element here and go down here and maybe I'll create let's see what other elements are. Okay, let's go with a calendar inline. All I have to do is drag it up there. And you can see what I mean. If you want to, if you really, really did want to, and you wanted to add multiple elements, say for example, a subheader afterwards saying, this is today, I don't know, then you could drag that just below it. So you can add multiple elements, not just one part. And of course, if I go back, if I click press that, this is today appears, and also the list for the calendar. So I'm gonna scratch all of these. Whoop. I'm gonna delete them all, so we've got a fresh page here. So I'm gonna create the one that I want to create is a morning log template. So let's go in, template button, brilliant. What shall I title it? Let's title it morning log, which I was gonna do it in a sec. Let's put a hashtag for a number that I will add. And then down below here, I'm going to press delete on this one. I'm going to create a new page. So a new page down here. And I'm going to, what I'm going to do on the page is put title it morning log hashtag. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a really simple structure to allow me to track my core focuses, my core achievements of the day, and maybe what happened in the day. So that's three core areas I want. So here we go. So I'm going to put a subheader. I'm going to put three core focuses. So these are the things that I want to focus on during my day. I'm going to put a divider just below it to neaten it up. Then I'm going to put another subheader. I'm going to put three achievements. Is that spelt right? I probably butchered. Oh, apparently there's a posh E in it. A French E. See, look, this is what's really going to hold me up is the spelling. I'm going to put a divider below that too. And again, I'm going to get rid of that second divider that's appeared. I'm going to get create another one called three things that happened with dot, dot, dot. And I could put a divider below that too. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this one about so it's in line with this one. So you can see here, and I'm going to put that divider down there. I'm going to put three simple bullet points as place markers, placeholders, next to all of these. So when I come onto this new template page, it pretty much has everything ready for me here. And I'm going to do that one. Again, you just have to play around with this page to what suits you. And naturally, over time, you're going to be adapting this. And then I'm also going to do the same here. So bullet, and three bullets. So I've got a real basic structure. I can even add icons here. So I might put like a picture of a, you could probably change the icon per day. So I'm going to put a picture of a, like a morning log sort of hand drawing there. And I'm also going to add a cover. In this demo, I'm actually going to upload one of the photos that I found the other week from Unsplash. So I believe it's that one. Quite a nice morning entry, I think. Like quite beautiful scenic. So I'm just going to drag up to the, there we go. So that appears. And as you can see here, this is all ready to go. I have pretty much my own morning log really briefly created here. So if I click morning, you'll see if I go back into the log. So I've created it down here. All I need to do is move it up into there. And logically, if I just change the title to log entry. Oop. Then I click close and I press log entry. What should appear is a new page there. So let's say I'm ready to go. Okay, so I'm gonna log entry one and I'm gonna say, well, four focuses today is record, Skillshare. And this could be in the morning, plan 6 month anniversary for wedding. Oh. You can see where I'm coming from, but it's a great morning log sort of process. This is something that I'm actually going to be starting to use, so this will be very helpful. Imagine I'm adding it for a second day in a row. Same icon appears. Number two. Very, very simple structure, but you've got yourself automatic log, and you can start adding these logs, and that's just a really simple demonstration of it. So hopefully you can go away with that one. I'll be using it over the next couple of weeks. I'll probably need to delete these two, and I'll be using it to experiment with. And maybe in a few weeks, I have a better idea of what the template happens. So you can use many of the advanced functions inside there to really create your own template button, and that's really how to take it above the norm. So guys, hopefully you enjoyed this feature. Just another note, actually, if you wanted to, you could create your own archive page really, really simply by just typing archive and putting a box. Archive like that. Then once you create them and you start adding them and you want to necessarily be able to drag them into there, you can do. And then that you've created your own archive area. Anyway, really simple, but hopefully it helps you. Let me know in the comments what you think. Join the Notion guidebook on Skillshare. It'd be great to have you. And feel free to join the new Facebook group, Notion Made Simple. Anyway, guys, big thank you. And I'll see you guys very soon. Cheers.